It's now more than 6 years since Alexander Litvinenko died after ingesting the rare and highly radioactive isotope polonium-210 in London. But it looks like we will have to wait a little longer for an impartial assessment of the complete circumstances surrounding his death. Today saw a resumption of the inquest into the events of 2006. But the essential message from the coroner was that he could do little until the British government has decided whether to hold a public inquiry into Mr. Litvinenko's death. Judge Robert Owen last month said he could not be sure that the proceedings he is overseeing would be full, fair and fearless, because the UK government has barred testimony that relates to any role played by the Russian state in the poisoning on the grounds of national security. Russia comes into the case because Britain is seeking the extradition of two former KGB agents in connection with the poisoning. They met with Mr. Litvinenko in a London hotel and have been named as prime suspects in the case by British police. Both men deny vehemently any involvement. The UK government has also banned any discussion on whether the British security services should have done more to protect Mr. Litvinenko, a former KGB officer who left Russia and began working for the British and Spanish security services. On May the 17th, Judge Owen took the unusual step of saying the restrictions meant his inquiry could not fully investigate how the poisoning came to happen. But a public inquiry, he said, might be able to. That's because while secret evidence cannot be heard in inquests, it can at public inquiries, meaning the evidence the British government wants to keep confidential could be heard in closed session. So today the judge repeated his call for such an inquiry, saying it was of paramount importance that the government came to a decision without further delay. Speaking outside the inquest, Alexander Litvinenko's widow, Marina, said she had lost faith in its ability to uncover the truth about his death. And she stressed she too wanted a public inquiry.
First of all, I would like to say I'm absolutely clear now is the only public inquiry will help me get justice.
But while the inquest might not reveal much about Mr. Litvinenko's death, it has shone a spotlight on the actions of the British government. Lawyers for Marina Litvinenko revealed she had been directly contacted by a senior aide to Foreign Office Minister David Lidington on the very same day, May the 11th, that David Cameron met Russian President Vladimir Putin. The minister apparently wanted to assure her that that meeting would have no impact on the inquiry. Neil Garham QC, a lawyer for the government at today's inquest, called that a courtesy call. But Ben Emerson QC, Mrs. Litvinenko's lawyer, said to seek direct communication in this way with an interested party in such a high-profile inquiry was quite improper. Judge Owen himself said he was astonished at the call. Questioned by reporters about whether she felt intimidated, Mrs. Litvinenko said she felt squeezed by both the British and Russian governments.
I can't say I fight against British government, but it seems I'm in front of very strong two sides. Russia state, what we blame behind of murdering of my husband, and now British government who doesn't help me to get this.
The suspicion is that the British government might be seeking to neuter any inquiry into the killing. There's no firm evidence of that, but the glacial speed at which the legal process has gone does raise eyebrows. And if the British government now refuses the request of a senior judge to replace his inquest with a public inquiry, even more questions will be asked.